rising number of new neighborhoods are being built around farms. These suburban housing developments are called agri-hoods. Neighbors can work on fully functional farms and bring fresh produce home. The trend is spreading across the country. There are agri-hoods in more than 24 states. Chip Reed is at one of the largest in Ashburn, Virginia. Chip, good morning.
Well, good morning. It's a beautiful day in the agri-hood. Yes, it's raining, but if you live in a community that has a farm right in the middle of it, you learn very quickly that rain is a good thing. That's how you get beautiful cucumbers and flowers and tomatoes like these. All of it grown right here on the community farm.
Oh, there's a lot of ripe ones here.
It might look like work, but for these kids, picking bushels of blackberries and ripe tomatoes.
This is the elbow right here. We're going to put your thumb there and snap that off.
Is the perfect way to spend a summer day on the farm.
Good one.
With strange creatures.
What is that?
A tomato hornworm.
I'm not going to ask what you're going to do with them.
Oh my God, we're going to be in a chicken.
And delightful surprises.
Oh, we got an egg.
Their harvest soon becomes lunch.
We are going to have an awesome cucumber and tomato salad.
Oh, that sounds good.
That's what Bonnie Moore loves to hear.
Tastes good, I know, right?
As the culinary director at Willowsford Farm, she's introducing the kids to this one right in their backyard. With 300 acres of working farmland and 2,000 acres left for conservation, it's one of the largest agri-hoods in the country. And it's part of a rising trend in housing, with over 200 agri-hoods across the nation. From Dallas, Texas, to outside of Atlanta, Georgia, even inner city Detroit and Southern California, they're bringing families back to a more rural life.
Why do you think this is a booming idea for how to live?
I think people want to know where their food comes from. I think parents want to know what their kids are eating, and they want their kids to be able to identify with food.
They're not just identifying their food.
Why does it feel good to eat cucumbers that you grew instead of buying them at the store?
I just feel, proud. I grew it. I picked it, and now I get to cut it and eat it.
They're owning it.
So when you look at this salad, what do you think?
Fresh.
Rewarding. It's rewarding? Fresh?
Because we picked it.
And it's not just about veggies. They're also managing the land, and no lawnmower is as much fun as a herd of goats. To the kids, Deborah Dramby is Farmer Deb, an expert on goats, healthy eating, and the importance of getting outside in nature.
So how important is it to get kids out here instead of in their houses doing whatever they do on their devices?
Well, gosh, remember when you were out of school because you spent the summer working on a farm, right? And instead of being inside on a device, playing a video game about farming or, you know, whatever exists, they can actually come and do it.
For the goats to do their job, the kids have to do theirs, making sure they have plenty of fresh water.
Do you like doing this work?
Totally.
You do. Why? Because you're doing it for the goats?
Yeah.
Unlike veggies, goats give back.
You get to hug animals and you get to take care of them, and that's really satisfying.
Who here loves working with goats? Who here could see being a farmer someday?
This could have been a golf course, but it's not. It's a farm. It's way better.
Why is it better?
It's so much more interactive. They want their families to be able to identify with something that's real. Real food, a real farm.
Melissa Miller says her children love to be off the phones and video games and on the farm.
It's just so exciting. They're seeing where their food's coming from, and they're having a healthier lifestyle because of it. And I think they'll agree, it's so fresh.
Every morning I kept saying, can I have more blueberries?
So blueberries taste better when you pick them yourself?
Yeah, I think they're at the farm and they're much fresher.
This is literally farm to table.
It is farm to table. And just the peaceful nature. We all have stressful lives with work and families and friends, but still just to drive down the street, you kind of have your moment.
Not quite like the TV show Green Acres, but a little bit along those lines.
Something like that, yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So on a summer morning when it's raining, what are most kids doing? They're sleeping late, they're watching TV, or they're on their numerous electronic devices. Your parents tell me that you'd rather be out here organizing the community farm market than being home in bed or watching TV. Are they right?
Yeah.
They really are?
Yeah.
Okay, well, there you have it, straight from the farmer's mouth. Vlad, back to you.
That is a great story, and it's so great to see kids out there enjoying the sunshine, learning how to farm. You can't beat that.
Looks like Chip had fun, too.
He did have fun. Chip, thank you. And